delightful and charming and very welcoming. And he allows you to explore and play. And it's a lovely, chilled, relaxed atmosphere on set, which is for any person, any kind of domain, what you can wish for.
Something that appealed to me about this was the dreamwalking nature of this film. The idea that you could time travel and the idea of reflecting, the idea of uncovering your memories could be so critical and so important.
And that's where Rose's character kind of comes in, and we recognize that there's a whole world of witches out there that can coexist as long as they're not dealing with the dark arts effectively.
I love that with Chloe, she has a power that she doesn't necessarily want to tap into. She's afraid of just how mentally strong she may be with dreamwalking and what it involves. And she's always believed that that is an evil trait to have.
Beautiful place.
Thank you.
How much do you charge?
Well, that depends on what you're buying.
A memory. It was fun to play with the dream realm.
There is a comedic release, I think, with Chloe taking a selfie.
And action.
I'm so scary now, are you? And it is, it's very funny. Vin was brilliant on that day. It was very, very funny. Kind of like, yeah, it shakes me off, it scares me. So it's cool.
Say witch hunter.
Witch hunter. Be nice.
It was a big scope of sets and being able to create a world that is from our imaginations but looks real, so that you, the viewer, to go into this world and be like, wow, this place is magical or this place is scary, but not feel like it's fake.
It's a memory bath. It's incredible. So the feel that Breck and Julie wanted was a kind of like open den. So you have your little kind of like alcoves that you can go in and you can just relax and just kind of transcend into another world.
I wanted it to have like a nature connected to it. My set decorator showed up with these beautiful beetles one day. I'm like, oh my gosh, that's the color palette for the memory bar. And so there's nature in there, and that was what Chloe's bar needed to be. It needed to be about a witch who's into herbs and she's connected to nature, and that's where she gets her powers from.
And then all the incredible props we had, you know, goat eyes and alcohol. We had all kinds of very disturbing things which would belong in a witch's bar.
We had a lot of witch potions to create with. We start with a pile of chemicals or hardware, and you actually spend a little part of your R&D is playing with it and say, well, that's kind of boring. How about this? How about that? Let's try some iron filings. How about some titanium? How about some Elmer's glue? What gives you something that's interesting to look at?
Breck didn't want the stereotypical witches. He didn't want the witches with a pointy hat. In many scenes in the memory bar, many of our characters, they are just unconventional, very interesting.
I think we spent 10 days on that one scene, and it gets burnt down. We use these big flame bars.
Bring up the front flame bar, please.
Just erupted. So it was really, really exhilarating. I loved it. And then I got to try and put it out with a fire extinguisher, which is the first time I've ever used a fire extinguisher, which I'm very lucky for, touch wood.
Hi.